Peter Fowler's back with me on Skype this morning from Westminster Group. Peter, good morning. Good to see you.
Good morning, Andrew. How are you?
I'm good, thanks, Peter. Look, this deal here, this news this morning around the Gulf Aviation Academy. Tell me a bit more about this. Who are they? What do they do?
GAA, the Gulf Aviation Academy, is a well-established aviation training school, training academy in Bahrain, covering the Middle East. So they cover all aviation training programs, pilots, air traffic control, and so forth, and of course, security.
So what services will you be providing here?
Under the strategic alliance, what we will be doing is both parties will be sharing and collaborating on training programs. So they bring a whole range of training programs that we don't have. So that opens up new opportunities for us. And of course, we're bringing to the party some advanced security training programs. So it's an important strategic move.
Indeed. Will you be doing some of this training here in the UK?
Absolutely. So we've opened a training academy some months back here in the UK, and the training is going to be collaborative both in Bahrain and in the UK, and frankly, joint ventures around the world at various airports.
So they're quite a sizable firm.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Is it too tricky to say as far as what your expectations are around revenues at this point?
Yes, I think it's a bit premature for that. We don't have numbers in the market, so I don't think it'd be right for me to talk about that. But what I would say is the strategic value of this arrangement is far greater than revenues. When you think that what we're doing is we're training senior management in airports in exactly the same areas that we would like to expand our major managed services business. So it's a great door opener for us.
So this is one of those, because I know the last time you and I spoke, you were talking about you're keen to increase the number of managed services contracts. This is one of those, is it?
No, this is just an enabling contract. So this is just one of the many initiatives we have going on. But our large scale managed services projects, there's a number of those that we're working on in the background.
Right. You've been speaking to the Gulf Aviation Academy for some time as far as this deal, have you? How did it come about?
Well, we're both fairly well known in the industry, so we come across each other quite often, and it made sense to start a collaborative discussion. So we've been discussing this arrangement for about 9 months.
And when does it actually start?
Immediately. Starts today. So we're off and running. It's a 3-year contract with a revolving 3-year renewal.
Look, Peter,
I think one interesting point just to bring out is, and I think we put it in the RNS, that the International Civil Aviation Authority, ICAO, which is a UN body, the regulatory body for aviation, have only 35 centres around the world where ICAO courses can be conducted. And GAA are one of those centres. So now by this strategic alliance, we have access to all of that, which is a really important move for us.
And another important move that's happened since you and I last spoke, this Saudi deal, is it with Hazar?
Yes, an amazing deal for us. We've been working on that one for a year or more, but very strategic move for the business. The opportunities in Saudi Arabia for our business in ports, harbours and so forth is immense. But to do that, you have to have a really strong partner as well as a local presence. So we're setting up Westminster Arabia with Hazar. Hazar, incidentally, are very well established over 30 years, very strong player with extremely good connections in Saudi. And their chairman, Sheikh Salman, very, very well connected guy. So it's a really important opportunity for us.
And a massive deal on its own, this one. It's, what are we talking, 28 airports or thereabouts?
Yeah, absolutely. 20 airports and, substantial number of seaports as well. We're already in discussions. I mean, there's no certainty, as we often say, no certainty of outcome or timing on these things, but the opportunities are immense and, I'm quite excited about it.
And what about the Tema deal that you and I last spoke about? Has that that port's officially opened now?
Yes, the port opened last week. It's a soft start at the moment. It's a sensible way forward. So they're processing, trialing the containers as they go through from the cranes to the screening, everything through the port. So they're unloading, unloading as ships as we speak, and I think activity will ramp up over the next few weeks.
And so have you finalised those terms now, have you?
No. We'll announce final terms when we do it, but we're fully operational. We're operational 24 hours a day. Everything's going to plan. And indeed, our CFO, Mark Hughes, is out in Ghana next week. So he's dealing with some commercial and financial issues, and we'll see.
And aside from all this, as you say, work towards securing further managed services contracts, that's ongoing.
Absolutely. I mean, these do take quite a while, as our investors know, but there's a whole raft of these. And I think what we're demonstrating at the moment, that there's an awful lot going on in the background that, you know, I'm looking forward to talking about in the months to come.
Well, you do have an awful lot going on for a company worth, what, 24, 25 million pounds?
Yes, we do indeed. But I could put that the other way around. I could say, how can a company who's got so much going on only have 24 million market cap? So we need to work on that.
Well, and to which your answer would be?
We're undervalued.
Have you got sufficient cash to see you through the current operations and what you've got going on at the moment?
I'm not going to be drawn on cash issues, but of course, you know, timing is everything, isn't it? So is now a good time to raise capital? It's better than it was last week, but it might not be as good as it may be in a week or two's time. So I'm not going to get drawn.
But Peter, always good to speak with you. Thanks very much indeed for your time this morning.
My pleasure. Thank you very much.